Ragazzi, buongiorno a tutti, sono Andrea Scuto, ho l'onore di essere qui nella fabbrica in Orange County, Southern California, con una leggenda vivente del guitar building e con Mr. John Sir.
Hello.
So, oggi ci farà vedere come nascono le chitarre Sir, dal legno alla finitura in vernice al testing, e quindi passerei la parola a John che ci farà vedere. So, John, if you can just give us a brief introduction on how you pick the food and how everything starts.
Magic.
Well, the magic starts with talking to the customer to try and see what tones he wants out of his guitar. Everything is about the wood, the neck, the body, and the vibration of the whole instrument. If the guitar doesn't sound good unplugged, it won't sound good plugged in. So then the key is we need to make sure that the electronics capture that beauty and bring it to the final product. Everything sounds so different. There's no right or wrong. We have Carina wood up there. We have river recovered wood that is 200 to 400 years old. We don't even know how old some of it is. Sometimes we do. Here we have roasted maple. This is my favorite right now, because with this wood, we have taken all the impurities out of the wood, all the sap, everything that stops it from vibrating is gone. So it's free to vibrate with all its natural tone. The beauty of this wood too is that it doesn't move. So I could put water on one side, normally the wood is gonna go back. This wood's not gonna move.
And is this from the treatment you gave it?
This is the way it's treated. This is baked in an oxygen-free kiln at a much higher temperature than we normally dry our normal wood. It's the same wood, it's just treated differently.
And you do the process yourself?
No, we don't do this. We have someone do it for us. We're not the only person that uses this, but it's just a new thing for us. One thing we did do is we started to have some of our body spreads also heat treated. And they get very light and very resonant, as if they've been sitting in a forest for 500 years dry. So this is the most exciting thing for me, for the tone.
Do you have a little control over this process? Or you just buy it and see how it goes with every batch?
We use all of our wood and then they treat it.
Okay. Under your specific words.
Yeah. I mean, they actually do other things in other industries with the same process, because termites don't like it anymore. I mean, so it helps to treat like even a wood deck, you know, with this kind of process. But the best thing about this process is it gets rid of all the sap, all the things that stop the wood from vibrating get taken out of the wood. Nice note. Unfortunately, a big problem with many musicians is the weight of their guitar, how much it weighs. Usually someone walks into a guitar store, they pick up a guitar. If it's too heavy, they just put it back. They don't even want to try it. So all the numbers you see here, we actually weigh all of our wood before it's cut. So we have a pretty good idea of how much each one of these is going to weigh when it's finished. And that's my big thing right now, is storing a lot of wood. Each one of those maple blocks over there is $500. So,
as you can see, it's a lot of money just sitting here in a pile, but this isn't the best one. But it's a pretty nice piece there.
So we like to hoard wood. We keep as much wood as we can. Paul Farrell here, more maple, Honduras mahogany, quarter sawn maple, more mahogany, Carina ash, alder. When we buy this wood, we join it. Before we join it, we actually re-dry it in our own kiln just to make sure that it's 100% we need to be about 5% humidity, moisture content. This is a nice one here. That's a burl maple.
Wow.
So you can tell there's a lot of collection of wood here. And then we have more in the other room too.
When somebody orders a guitar,
this is a roasted, one of the roasted pieces. So far, the only thing that's touched this is the CNC. So no handwork has been done on this yet. We let this neck sit here for 1 month to make sure that the neck's not gonna move. Because once you relieve all this wood on the back, the neck could twist or it could do anything funny. But to make sure that everything is stable when it goes to their customer, it sits here for a month. If everything is good, then we go ahead and then we final true the fingerboard, we fret it, and we cut the body.
So do we have the CNC machine here somewhere?
Oh yeah. Okay, we'll go look at them. So unfortunately, if a neck sits here and in 1 month we don't like the way it looks, then it's gonna get rejected and we're gonna start over again. And because each one is custom made, it's got a custom order for that person. Sometimes, unfortunately, he has to wait an extra month.
Yeah, that's what I wanted to ask you. So what is your usual time span when you take a custom order for being completed?
It takes about 2 months to build it.
2 months?
But we're about 7 months back ordered right now.
Okay. Because of this complete quality control that you want to have. You want to make sure you deliver.
And you're waiting in line, too.
Yeah, for a reason.
Yeah.
I mean, it's not just, we're not waiting in line because of some fussy ideas of make people waiting in line. But because, for example, I order a guitar, you start to build it, you don't like the way
it looks,
you're not
going
to sell it.
Trash.
Yeah, so. Oh yeah, that makes a lot of sense. Yeah.
And the actual build process is not the majority of the time. It's all the waiting in between the steps that takes all the time. And plus, we have a lifetime warranty on our necks. So if anything happens to your neck 10 years later, I'm replacing it for free. So I don't want to have any problems. So everything I do is to make sure that there's never a problem, because if I have to remake a neck, I lost twice as much money as I made.